I love eating avocados. I think they're delicious, as clearly did people in South America. They've been cultivating them for over 5,000 years. But they're a curious fruit. They've got a very thick skin. They've got a large seed in the middle. So you can ask, what on earth used to disperse these? And rather surprisingly, Daniel Jansen and Paul Martin showed that the disperser is this creature here, the giant ground sloth, this terrifying beast. Although it turns out this is a vegetarian. It rises on its back feet in order that it can stand up and eat fruit and vegetation. The giant ground sloths went extinct about 11,000 years ago, soon after humans arrived in that area. And then there were pumpkins. Pumpkins used to be fist size and rather bitter, but they were dispersed by mastodons, relatives of elephants. And again, they went extinct about the same sort of time after humans arrived. So Jansen and Martin suggest it's useful to think of fruit like this as anachronistic fruit, fruit whose main dispersers are no longer in existence. And we're seeing something similar nowadays. Many of our large dispersers are showing large crashes in population. If you think of primates, of hornbills, of parrots, and fruit bats, all of those are declining. And it's likely that there will be consequences for the dispersal and regeneration of forests. And we can see it on another scale within Europe. A number of the dispersers are also declining, thrushes and species like that. So in order for species not to go the way of the wild avocado and have viable populations, it's important that we ensure that dispersers persist and are not driven extinct.